Honor a just announced the Honor 8 Pro for Europe, starting at €549. Honor's biggest, highest-end handset is a supersized, supercharged version of one of our favorite affordable flagships of the past year. Offering gorgeous design, speedy performance, and legendary battery life for less money than you expect to pay. Watch this video to discover the 2017 flagship killer from Honor. Honor and Huawei have been doing a good amount of cross-pollination with the way it renamed some of its smartphones for other markets. This time, Honor is announcing a new smartphone for the European market. The Honor 8 Pro is a rebranded device that is otherwise known as the Honor V9 in China. Honor is really blurring the line between its two brands with its smartphone. While Honor has been keener about being a hyper-value brand, this is the first smartphone to break the 500 plus euros price range. By contrast, last year's priciest device from Honor was the Honor 8. It was priced at 400 euros when it launched last summer. The Honor 8 Pro features a QHD 5.7-inch display, which trumps the Mate 9 in terms of resolution. Performance-wise, the Honor 8 Pro packs the Kirin 960. The chipset is the company's most powerful SoC to date. That's the same CPU found in the Huawei Mate 9 and the more recent Huawei P10. Not to mention, the Honor 8 Pro comes with an octa-core CPU and also makes use of 6GB of RAM and will come with 64GB of internal storage. The Honor 8 Pro has exceptional graphic processing by the Vulkan API. The industry-leading Vulkan API looks set to be the future of mobile gaming. The Vulkan delivers significant improvements over its predecessor OpenGL by relieving the CPU train, processing image gallery, and UI effects, raising the device graphical and data processing capabilities. All-round graphic performance is enhanced up to 400%. This enables the most demanding games to run at high frame rates with minimum lagging. In the last round of Honor Phone launches, we were still bemoaning the old IMUI 4.1 based on a Marshmallow, which was the last vestige of the truly bad Huawei software. Since then, we have been treated to the significantly improved IMUI 5, with Honor 8 having received an updated version in recent weeks. IMUI 5.1 builds on that foundation, mainly adding low-level optimization to what was steady and a stable and fast software setup. The new point release is still based on Android 7.0, not the newer 7.1, which is a little disappointing point, but in reality, you are not missing out on much in the way of user-facing features. In any case, when you combine that with a proven CPU and 6GB of RAM, you've got a phone that's lightning fast. The new version of EMUI also benefits from the complete facelift that came in EMUI 5, making it much easier on the eyes than older phones running version 4 of the software. The notification area no works the way Google intended, and EMUI is not as aggressive as customizing your app icons anymore. There are still plenty of iOS influences here, mostly in the launcher, but elsewhere, UI has settled into a cool blue and white color palette and it works pretty well. Back around the front, the Honor 8 Pro boasts a Quad HD 2460 by 1440 pixels IPS LCD display, the biggest we have seen in an Honor phone to date, a panel which technically makes it a phablet. The display is bright and vivid, beating the OnePlus 3T in daylight visibility as well as pixel density. And colors are vibrant without appearing oversaturated, with no noticeable ghosting or overtly unbalanced use. Should you want to tweak things further, there is a white balance option available. Overall, it's comparable to the slightly smaller Quad HD panel Huawei uses in the P10 Plus and a handset which sells for around 200 euros more. Honor has somehow crammed a 4000 mAh cell into a relatively compact handset, and as the numbers would suggest, that makes the 8 Pro an extremely dependable performer, even with heavy use. The 4000 mAh high-density battery, combined with the Smart Power 5.0 technology, will bring you an ultra-long life battery. The Honor 8 Pro will take you through 2 full days with regular use and near 1.44 days with heavy use. The camera hardware has not changed a whole lot since the Honor 8, with dual 12-megapixel cameras around the back, behind focal of 2.2 lenses, with a laser autofocus module, no hidden off to the left. As before, the phone combines one full color RGB sensor with another monochrome sensor for improved contrast and detail in challenging lighting conditions. But don't let these hardware similarities fool you. The Honor 8 Pro absolutely takes better photos than the 8, particularly in low light conditions. To summarize the specification of the new flagship killer, the Honor 8 Pro is armed with the latest Kirin 960 processor, which is accompanied by blazing Mali G71 graphics. Manufactured by Honor's parent company Huawei, it's the same octa-core chipset found within the Mate 9, which is plenty powerful, with the latest Cortex A73 top-shelf cores. Furthermore, on offer are no less than 6 GB of LPDDR4 RAM and 64 GB of expandable storage, so Honor is bringing its A game to Europe. The display is a 5.7-inch TFT LCD effort, boasting a Quad HD resolution panel. The Honor 8 Pro gets a sizable 4000 mAh battery, which is the same capacity as the Mate 9 juice pack. The camera hardware has not changed a whole lot since the Honor 8, with dual 12-megapixel cameras around the back. Clearing up some of the smaller matters, the dual SIM device includes the fingerprint scanner, USB Type-C, and of course LTE. Measuring in at 157 by 77 by 7 mm and weighing 184 grams, the Honor 8 Pro chips with UI newest EMUI 5.1 atop the Android 7.0 Nougat firmware. Finally, the Honor 8 Pro comes in black, blue and gold and will be available for purchase from April 5th onwards in select markets including the United Kingdom, France, Germany, Italy, Spain and Switzerland for 549 euros. What do you think of the Honor 8 Pro announced by Honor? Do you think it will be the 2017 flagship killer? Tell us in comments. To discover more Android related content, don't hesitate to subscribe to the SRL channel.